Hey there, Nation. Welcome to the show where we help you to play miniatures war game on a budget. It is I, Commander Cheapskate, and we are back with another edition of the Kill Team Chronicles. This is our series of Warhammer 40,000 Kill Team Battle Reports, and this is Battle Report number 4. It is a Disrupt the Supply Line scenario that is fought between my friends Odeath as well as Sister Serial. Odeath is bringing the Golden Scions, a Thousand Suns Warband, and Sister Serial is bringing Precinct 13, a Tempestus Scions Warband. So the very first time these four warbands are fighting it out, and to make things a little bit more interesting, my friends decided to fight out in the terrain setup that we call the Tombs. It is an underground labyrinth that we use for a lot for our Necromunda battle reports, and my two friends wanted to use that one to play the scenario one. So we're pretty excited to see that one again because it's been a while since we've been into the Tombs. So, with that being said, we're going to play some background music real quick. If you want to see exactly what each of the kill teams is bringing, go ahead and pause and take a look at your own leisure. So, with that being said, let's get this battle report on a roll. Alright, so here's overhead shot of the battlefield, and this brings us to our scenario rules. As you can see, we are fighting in the Tombs on this one. This is a Disrupt Supply Lines mission. It's a typical attacker versus defender type of mission. The attacker is trying to destroy three objectives, while the defender is trying to defend those three objectives. Whoever holds those objectives is 3 victory points for each objective that is held. The attacker also receives 1 additional victory point if they destroy an objective, and the defender also gains an additional victory point if they manage to break the attacker's kill team. Whoever has the most victory points in the end wins the scenario. As a result for the scenario, if the defender loses 2 materiel if they are defeated, and the attacker loses 1 morale if they are defeated. So, with the scenario rules over with, as well as overhead shot of the battlefield, let's go and talk about deployment real quick. Alright, so starting with Precinct 13, in the bottom left-hand corner, we have objective number 1 that is being protected by, looks like 3 members of the Tempestus Scions. The guy up front is Judge Gosling's armed with a melted gun, as well as Judge Vasquez, who is armed with a heavy flamer. I'm not sure what the third judge's name is in the back, but that's just a normal Tempestus Scion, who's armed with a hotshot laser rifle. So that's where the kill team for this group is deployed. At the same time, here is a close-up of the other two objectives for this battle report. Up in the very top, we have objective number 2. Defending that one looks like the Interceptor, as well as Judge Vasquez. And Judge Vasquez, who's armed with a flamer. And then right behind him is another judge armed with a hotshot laser rifle. And then in the center there, we got objective number 3 that is controlled by Judge Fear, who's the leader of this group, as well as our comm specialist, Judge Mason. And then 2 more judges as well, armed with hotshot laser rifles. And they're defending the objective there in the middle. So with deployment for the Tempestus Scions over with, let's go over to the Thousand Suns. On the right-hand side of the table, you can see that my friend Odeath has deployed his leader, who is Sekinre the Illuminator, as well as one of his veterans who's armed with a warp flamer, and right behind them is another Rubric Marine, and he has his 2 Zangor fighters as well. I believe one of them is his combat specialist, leading the front there on the bottom of the screen. And on the top of the map, there's 2 more members of the Golden Scions. Up in the front is, I think his name is Ranhotep. That's the heavy gunner for this kill team. He's armed with a Soul Reaper cannon. And then right behind him is another Rubric Marine as well. And so with deployment done, we go to the top of turn number 1. And both my friends roll off for initiative to see who goes first. So that takes us to turn number 1 for the Golden Scions. As you can see from this overhead shot of the battlefield, there has been some dramatic movement taking place throughout the entire of the battlefield. As you can see, my buddy Odeath has decided to divide up his kill team into 2 parts, one attacking from the top of the maze while the other half is deployed on the bottom of the half of the maze. At the same time, it looks like Sister Serial, she decides to divide up her forces as well. She sends 2 portions of her kill teams to intercept the 2 invading Thousand Suns are coming up from the top as well as the bottom, but she keeps about half of her kill team in reserve as well to defend the three objectives on her side of the table as well. So as you can see, there's a lot of dramatic movement taking place. Looks like Zangors are also charging forward to attack one of the judges in the bottom of the screen, as well as the rest of the Root Marines kind of moving into support positions right behind the Zangor. So with that being said, let's go ahead and zoom in real quick and talk about where all the movement's taking place. On the bottom of the screen here, you can see that one of the Zangor, I believe it's just the one who's armed with a chain sword as well as auto pistol, charged directly into Judge Mason. So because that, he's engaged in close combat. At the same time, you can also see the other Zangor in the background, in the middle of the chamber there, bringing him support with the rest of the Rurik Marines follow closely behind them. Meanwhile, on the left-hand side of the battlefield, Sister Seriel has kept Judge Fear as well as Judge, I believe that's Judge Mason, the comm specialist, and two judges right there in the middle of her deployment area to watch over the other three objectives to, you know, defend them to make sure that the Thousand Suns don't get to them as well. At the same time, you can see on the right-hand side, another judge has entered the middle of the intersection, so that way he has three fields of fire that he could shoot down to in case he needs to do some fire support. Here's a close-up of the middle of the table. As you can see, Odeth has deployed one of his Zangar, I believe that's his combat specialist, in the middle chamber of the tombs. And then right behind them, you have the warp flamer wielding Rogue Marine, as well as another Rogue Marine armed with an Infernal Bolt Gun right behind them, leading support. At the top side, though, you could also see that my friend Sister Seriel has also deployed some of her kill teams moving forward. She has moved the Interceptor directly into the center chamber as well, so they have a nice little rear charge behind the Zangor in the next phase. At the same time, she's also moved up Judge Vasquez with his Heavy Flamer moving forward, so that way he can start shooting at any of the intercepting Rogue Marines coming his way. At the same time, you can see in the top of the screen there, the Soul Reaper cannon wielding Rubikai is up here on the top, taking close, careful aim at the Judge Vasquez, armed with a Heavy Flamer, and another Rogue Marine is also tucked in right behind him. Both of them have good, clear shots towards Judge Vasquez, which could be pretty rough because in the shooting phase, the one who has initiative goes first, so that's pretty deadly. At the same time, you can see that my buddy Odeth has also moved up his Aspiring Sorcerer, Zakinray Illuminator, to get within range to use his psychic abilities. So with the movement phase done, we go directly to the psychic phase. And the psychic phase, you can see here that my friend Odeth has tapped his sorcerer, used psychic bolt against the Interceptor, managed to put two mortal wounds onto the Interceptor as well, causing the very first casualty for the game. That guy goes out of action with the two mortal wounds that he takes. So because of that, Cicera loses her scout specialist, the Interceptor, and Chaka first blood for the Golden Scions. As you can see in the shooting phase, it ended up being just absolutely horrible for Sister Seriel in this case. The first thing that my friend Odeth does is that he activates his Heavy Gunner. He also uses to spend a command point on the More Bullets ability, I believe is what it's called. That's where you get to do an additional shot with the Heavy. So that Heavy is Ramotep, I believe is his name, of the Light. He carries a Soul Reaper Cannon. So he has already has four shots with that Soul Reaper Cannon. Add one more because of the More Bullets ability, and all five shots hit. And as you can see, not only do all five shots hit, but they also wound. He does cause one of them to be a flesh wound, but the rest of them basically put the guy out of action. So because of that, Sister Seriel has lost another member of her kill team, which is Judge Vasquez, and chalk up another one for the Rubrikai. In this case, as you can see here as well, the second Rubrikai in the back, he does take aim and try to shoot at the judge at the end of the hallway, but because he's partially obscured, because of the way that the corners are working on this one, he misses his shots, is unable to land any blows against him. At the same time, the judge, unfortunately, is not able to shoot back. Well, he actually does, I think he does hit the Rubrikai on the right-hand side, just the normal one armed with the Infernal Bolt Gun, but he's unable to wound because, you know, Laskins are not very powerful, and these are Space Marines he's going up against. So with the shooting phase over with, for the most part, we go directly to the combat phase. And the combat down the bottom of the page between the Zangor as well as Judge Mason, it goes horrifically wrong for Sister Seriel. That Zangor has no problem just basically decapitating that judge and taking him out. So because of that, that judge armed with the melted gun is out of action. At the same time, because of 3-inch follow-up, as you can see, he moves directly into close combat with Judge Drake. So because of the next turn, Judge Drake, as well as this Zangor, I believe his name is Unka, is his name. They're going to be fighting it out in the next combat phase in turn number two. So during the morale phase, both groups are fine. Nobody breaks or causes any shaken models to exist. So because of that, they pass nerve tests. So with that being said, we go to the top of turn number two. We roll for initiative to see who goes first. So this is the foe of the battlefield after the movement phase of turn number two. As you can see, the Golden Scions have once again won the initiative on this one, so things are not going very well for Sister Serial. And as you can see, the Rubrikai of the Thousand Sons of the Golden Scions just sweep quickly over to the middle of the table as well, and keep on advancing towards the Tempestus Scions. The first thing, as you can see in the bottom of the screen there, the Zangor combat specialist for my friend Odeth charges forward and directly gets in close combat with Judge Drake. So because of that, Judge Drake is outnumbered 2-1 against the Zangor. At the same time, he also maneuvers his other two Rubrikai directly to the center causeway there, heading over towards the left-hand flank. At the same time, at the top of the screen, as you can see, he's also maneuvering his forces forward again, sending up his Rubrikai with the Inferno Bolt Gun taking point. Right behind him is his Soul Reaper cannon wielding Rubrikai, and then right in the back is his Aspiring Sorcerer, Zenkrindere the Illuminator. At the same time, Sister Serial also starts maneuvering her forces to take up more defensive positions. As you can see, that center chamber where most of her forces were located at, she has now scattered her forces. First thing that she does on the bottom of the screen there, she pulls back one of her judges away from the combat between the Zangor as well as Judge Drake, so that way he can land some supporting fire. At the same time, at the top of the quarter, two more judges are also on the top there, so that way they can lend some supporting fire to that area as well. Judge Fear has also maneuvered to the intersection at the top of the tombs there, to intercepting that column of Rubrikai coming his way, with another judge watching his back. And then finally in the back there, in the center chamber, Judge Mason, which is the comm specialist, holds his ground to secure the center objective in the middle of the battlefield. Here's a close-up of the movement taking place in the bottom half of the tombs. As you can see, Anku and Unka, the two Zangor, have charged directly into Judge Drake. You can also see that the other judge in the back, I believe that's Judge Anderson, has kind of scooted back a little bit to defend objective number one in the bottom left-hand corner of the tombs, as well as lend some support fire. At the same time, you can see the other Rubrikai, I believe that's Ron is his name. He's the guy in the back there. He's on the right-hand side. He's moving forward, as well as the veteran under the Warflamer is in their center chamber taking cover to ready to move forward. And here's a close-up of the top of the tombs. As you can see that column of Rubrikai moving directly towards the objective number one on the top of the screen. And you can see Sister Serial has deployed her judges to start, you know, intercepting these intersections in order to start laying down some defensive fire as well. You can see Judge Fear's right in the middle there of the table, as well as the other judges kind of spread about in order to defend those other objectives as well. So with the movement phase over with, we go directly to the psychic phase. And in the psychic phase, my buddy Odeth taps Sekinray the Illuminator, who launches a psychic bolt directly to Judge Fear, which is the leader of Precinct 13, and lands three mortal wounds upon that guy. So that was absolutely horrific. Odeth rolled his D6, 2D6, and rolled an 11 again. So it was absolutely atrocious to see that damage taking place. So unfortunately for Sister Serial, Judge Fear does go out of action. He will need to roll up on the injury table to see what happens to him. So Sister Serial's troops are being picked off one by one. It's pretty unfortunate. Unfortunately for the shooting phase, Sister Serial was unable to land any wounds or to make any shots, and the rest of them could not fight because they're engaged in close combat. So because of that, we skip the shooting phase and go directly to the combat phase. And you can see in this picture, those two Zangor had no problem taking out Judge Drake. They do move forward 3 inches to reconciliate, start piling closer in order to get to Judge Anderson, who's on the bottom of the screen there. They just missed him by an inch, so because of that, Judge Anderson is okay for another round. But at the same time, though, those Zangor are looking dead hungry, and there's only this one lone Tempest Scion left to defend objective number one in the bottom left-hand corner of the tombs. So with that combat phase over with, they go to the morale phase. Everyone passes the morale test, so no one is broken, and nerves are still being held. So because of that, we go directly to the top of turn three, and we roll for initiative to see who goes first. Alright, so that takes directly to the top of turn number three, and this time our friend Sister Serial is able to snatch initiative on this one, so she gets to move around first. And as you can see, this photo is taken directly after the move phase, and as you can see, a lot of charging kind of takes place. Sister Serial unfortunately decided to kind of backpedal instead of gauging her opponents a little bit, and I think that was kind of like a mistake on this part, because then she loses the initiative that she was given. So as you can see, she keeps a couple of forces, kind of pulls them back in order to defend their objectives. At the same time, however, Odeth decides to take the offense. The first thing he does, he charges forward with his Zangor combat specialist against the Judge Anderson on the bottom left hand corner. So those two are now engaged in close combat. At the same time, he also charges his other Zangor, Unka, who goes up to the top and starts engaging the two judges are on the top of the screen there. At the same time, Odeth also fans forward with his two Rubrikai. I believe the one with the Warp Flamer goes to the left, heading towards objective number one, while the one who's armed with the Inferno Bolt Gun moves up the center corridor there, heading to objective number two. At the same time, on the top of the screen, as you can see, I believe the Rubrikai's armor, the normal Infernal Bolt Gun, he charged directly into the judge in the center corridor there on the top left corner of the screen, while he sends it as heavy to engage the other judge who's trying to defend the intersection between objectives 1 and 2, sorry, 2 and 3 on the upper left-hand corner of the screen. And of course, the aspiring sorcerer moves in to use another psychic bolt attack against the one remaining unengaged judge. So because of that, that pretty much rounds up the move phase on this one. Here's a close-up of the lower left-hand corner of the tombs. As you can see, that Zangor is engaged with that lone judge there near object number one, while the other two Rubrikai are starting to spread in into support areas, while the other Zangor deals with that judge in the top of the picture there. And here's a close-up of the upper left-hand corner of the tombs. As you can see, you can see that Rubrikai engage with that judge in the top of the page, while the heavy gunner is ready to shoot at the poor judge on the left-hand side, and the aspiring sorcerer getting ready to psychic bolt the next guy off the table. So with the move phase over with, we go directly to the psychic phase. So in the psychic phase, the aspiring sorcerer shoots forward with a psychic bolt against that lone judge. I believe that's Judge... Oh, what's the guy's name? Judge Mason, I believe is his name. That's the comm specialist. Aims at that psychic bolt. Not only does he cause one mortal wound, so he manages to put that guy out of action as well. So unfortunately for Sister Serial, she'll need to roll up on the injury table for Judge Mason to see exactly what happens to him. So with the psychic phase over with, we go directly to the shooting phase. And unfortunately for Sister Serial, she did open up with two shots from the hotshot laser rifle against the heavy wielding Rubrikai, but unfortunately was unable to wound this guy. Managed to hit him both times, but was unable to cause any wounds. So because of that, her shots were unfortunately missed out. My friend O'Death does activate the More Bullets ability on his heavy again and cuts loose with five shots. I believe all five shots hit and wounded, and I believe three of the five shots put this guy out of action. So because of that, this judge will need to roll up on the surgery table to see what happens to him as well. So with the shooting phase over with, we go directly to the combat phase. And in the combat phase, starting on the left-hand side, the Zangor has no problem putting the hurt on Judge Anderson and putting that poor guy out of action. He will need to roll up on the injury table after the end of the scenario. The Zangor Unka has no problem taking care of the one lone judge that was standing in his way in the central corridor, so that way it leaves open object number two to be conquered quickly with the Rubrikai right behind them. And finally, the very last judge who is holding out right here in the top of the corridor, he also gets the hurt put on him by the Rubrikai, who puts him out of action as well. So because of that, all three of those combats go to O'Death on that one. And as you can see, that takes directly to the end of the game. The Golden Scions win. As you can see, not a single Typestus Scion is left on the table. All of them have been taken out of action. It was just a very vicious, brutal just sweep across the battlefield by the Golden Scions against Precinct 13. It was absolutely atrocious. It was a massacre is what it was. Which is also kind of interesting because they're fighting in close quarters and these guys are Space Marines against normal Imperial Guardsmen. So, you know, it kind of figures in the lore it would happen this way. So that was pretty devastating for my friend Sister Serial. Great for my friend O'Death, but not so great for my other friend. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go directly to the post game and talk about exactly what happened to each of the kill teams, because this battle report is now officially over. Alright, now it's time for the post game. The very first kill team we're going to start off with is Precinct 13. For the injuries, every single member of this kill team got put out of action. So let's go and talk about exactly what happened to each one of them. Unfortunately for Sister Serial, Judge Fear, her leader, he died. Judge Drake the Heavy made a full recovery. The Interceptor, the Scout, made a full recovery. However, Judge Mason, the comm specialist, he died as well. Judge Gosling made a full recovery. Judge Vasquez has got convalescence, so because that, he will miss out on the next mission. And Judge Mattis also died as well. Meanwhile, Judge Hershey and Judge Anderson, they both make full recoveries. For advancements, she doesn't have enough experience points to advance any of her fighters, so because that, none of that takes place. For the recruitment phase, however, she did recruit three new judges. Judge Dredd is their new leader, followed by Judge Macklin, who's the new comm specialist, as well as Judge Cooper, is the new Tempestus Scion, replacing the one that got killed in her fire team. For her resources are at intelligence is 4, material is now 7. It used to be 9, but she lost 2 points of material due to the scenario rules. Her morale is 8, and her territory is still at 5. That brings her record also for this kill team to 0 wins, as well as 1 loss. Now then, as for the Golden Scions, not a single member of this kill team was injured, just because that there is no injury rules. For advancements, and Amon Hep of the Light, which is the heavy, he leveled up to level number 2. He learned the Overwhelming Firepower heavy skill, as well as extra armor. And Anku, who is the Zangor combat specialist, he gets level up 2 as well. He learns the defensive fighter trait, as well as the warrior adaptability as well. For this kill team's resources, their intelligence is at 4, materiel is at 7, morale 8, and territory 4, and their current record is at 1 win as well as 0 losses. So that's going to do it for this one, you guys. As always, please feel free to like, comment, and or subscribe. Your guys' input is invaluable to us as always. Also, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Google+, as well as Blogger.com for all these great news about our hobby. That's going to do it for this one, you guys. For the Kill Team Chronicles, number 4 is in the books. We will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.